afternoon is to introduce the MC, but before I get there, I just wanted to say thank you for everybody coming out. For me, first time I've ever been at a pageant. So I have the two boys, 30 and 28. My wife, Pam, here. If she's ever been to a pageant either. So it's the first time for us, so we're really looking forward to it. We appreciate that, and we really appreciate the got to know the Gurney Queens a little bit. And they've had a tough year. It's been tough in terms of COVID, as you might imagine, but they've come through with flying colors. It's really wonderful to see at events that they come out and they add a lot of color. Not so traditional like myself or a guy, need some girls doing that, so they've done a great job. Mia, Morgan, and Melanie are just a bright spot in things for Gurney. So as we do things in this coming year, we're looking forward to being able to be out in the public more. So we're looking forward to the new Queens that come on, and they're going to have lots of opportunities to be able to be part of Gurney. That's just so important to me and important to the village, important to the village board. So without further ado, I want to introduce the MC for this afternoon, Jenny Carlson McBride. I know Jenny, so I've got a list of things. Jenny's quite accomplished, and probably you guys all know her because she was 2009 Miss Gurney. She also was a pageant director for she also continued on with the program to stay in touch. She received a couple degrees, a master's. She teaches, taught middle school, and she's going to be at Stevenson High School, right? Well, I'm a Warren High School grad, so you can imagine how I feel about Stevenson. So you know what? But nonetheless, Stevenson has a great teacher now. So in any event, she's married, and she has married her husband Ryan for 6 years and has three children, Jackson, Skylar, and Matt. Matt is 8 weeks old. Wow. All right. So please join me in welcoming Jenny McBride.
Thank you. evening, everyone. I am Arya Aliya, contestant number one. And
Lee is a 29-year veteran, nationally board-certified teacher of the Spanish language and culture. In her personal life, she is the wife of her high school sweetheart, Dr. Brian Stack, a local pediatrician, as well as a dedicated dance mom to two daughters, ages 15 and 19. She is very proud of her younger daughter, Sophia, for the experience serving as second runner-up of Junior Miss Gurnee 2018, and is fueled her passion for poise, grace, and commitment to service. Lee is also a 39-year member and volunteer of the United Methodist Church of Libertyville, and currently serves on their board of trustees. Her hobbies include a love for gardening, gourmet cooking, and cookbook collecting. She is most thrilled to meet this year's candidates. Thank you so much, Lee. The Gurnee Community Pageant Board would like to thank all of our judges who have graciously volunteered their time to be here with us today. There are a few more people who we would like to thank. Our pageant would not be able to succeed or thrive if it wasn't for the help of many individuals throughout the year. We are eternally grateful for all of the support that you have given our program and the countless opportunities you've provided to our queens to be so involved within our community. A huge thank you goes out to our former Mayor, Christy Kabarik. Mayor Kabarik retired this spring, but our queens have been incredibly lucky to have her as a role model throughout the years. Thank you for all of the love and support you have given our pageant, and including the girls in all of the village events and ribbon-cutting ceremonies. Mayor Tom Foote, we are so excited and look forward to working with you this year and beyond. The Gurnee Park District. Our queens are kept very busy volunteering throughout the year with all of the fun events and programs that the Park District has to offer to our community. We are looking forward to some of our annual events returning this year. We also want to thank you for your generosity allowing us to hold our car wash fundraiser at the Health Club Community Center and for your flexibility in moving the pageant indoors today. Honey Orthodontics, thank you for your financial contribution to our Sweetest Smile recipients. We are so fortunate to have businesses in our community who value these young ladies as much as we do. Nothing Bunch Cakes, we are so grateful for the delicious fun that's donated to our contestants today. Black Art Video, we thank you for taking the time to video our pageant and preserve these memories for all of our contestants and queens. And all of our backstage volunteers. Today would not be possible without the help of all of them. Our 2020 Queen Families, many people don't realize how much time and effort is involved in supporting the girls during their reign, and we appreciate all that they have done to make this year one to remember. And finally, to our Gurnee Community Pageant Committee. This program continues to be a positive force due to the countless hours that you put in to make this program a success. Our pageant is all run by volunteers who hope to foster the next generation of leaders by promoting a love of service throughout the community. At this time, I would like to formally introduce our Little Miss Gurnee 2020, Melanie Mateos, who will be escorted by her dad, Adrian Mateos.
Most about being Junior Miss Gurnee?
Honestly, everything.
everything. I can't pick just one thing because there were so many amazing parts of my reign, and there's no way I can just pick one thing.
Okay, my next question for you is, tell me a piece of advice that you might have for the new Junior Miss Gurney.
I would have to say, cherish every single memory. I'm pretty sure you can ask every single queen or anybody who's even been involved in pageants that there have been so many amazing times in their reign, and there are so many people that you get to meet and just amazing things. Thank you.
Thank you so much for your presentation. And finally, I would like to formally introduce our Miss Gurney 2020, Mia Johnson, who is escorted by her friend, Cassidy Sutton.
Thank you. they could deliver a speech in front of all these people, and you guys were amazing. Let's hear it for them again.
Brooke is 11 years old.
years old. This fall, she will be a seventh grader at Woodland Middle School.
Okay, ready to give your speech?
By adding the title of Junior Miss Renee, I will have more opportunity to work with my sister Queens on community projects, like donating food and clothing items to various charities, hosting events to get more people involved in my platform of making food funds, to donate to hospitals and school nurses near me. When I'm not helping out in my community, you can find me singing, dancing, playing lacrosse, and rollerblading. I also would like to participate in different events where I can promote giving back to my community. Thank you.
Brooke is involved in lacrosse, cheer, competitive dance, and designing handmade masks. If Brooke could have any superpower, it would be the ability to fly and have superhuman strength so that she could help save people from harm. Thank you, contestant number two, Brooke. She is a company member at STEPS Performing Arts Center, and she is a most fun for high school dance team. Emily's superhero power would be the ability to fly. She loves to travel, and it would be so easy to go anywhere in the world when she wants and where she wants. Thank you, contestant number one, Emily. Next, we have contestant number two, Bella Jansen. Bella is 18 years old. This fall, she will begin her freshman year at St. Omer College in Dubuque, Iowa, Wisconsin. Are you ready to give your speech?
Growing up, my mother operated her own Aspen daycare here in Gurnee. There, I had the opportunity to meet lots of local families. However, one family impacted me more than they will ever know. One morning, my mother received a text message. The father of the sweetest young girl had unexpectedly passed away. When I heard the news, my heart sank. It hurt me to know that this young and full of life girl would now have to struggle to wonder why her father had seemingly disappeared. And that a woman who just lost the love of her life, her best friend, and the father of her child would now have to endure the struggles that come with becoming a single mom overnight. But she knew she had to persist, regardless of the difficulties that lie ahead. My platform, serving and supporting single mothers, will not only empower these women, but also help the lives of these children who are heavily impacted by having a single parent. These women and children deserve a fair shot at building a beautiful, safe, thriving lives for themselves. But it won't happen overnight. We must continue to speak up for the single mothers so they can become a positive influence in the lives of their children and break the chain of poverty, lack of education, and low self-esteem. We can help raise the future leaders of tomorrow, but first we must help single mothers today. Thank you.
Bella's superhero power would be to time travel. The thought of being able to travel back in time and experience major events would be an opportunity she would not want to pass up. Thank you, contestant number two, Bella. Now we would like to welcome back our Miss Contestants to the stage for their ensemble review. Let's hear it for them one more time. Were they both amazing? Thank you, Miley. Girl, you should be so proud of yourselves. You've done such a wonderful job. Can you find your family and friends in the audience? A little thing that's so much cooler than you guys. Thank you so much, ladies. We will see you back on stage shortly. One of our traditions during the pageant is to recognize and invite all of the Lake County visiting royalty from past and present to the stage. Our queens would like to present you with a special gift to thank you for all of your support and friendship throughout the year. These girls form bonds that last a lifetime. We have something special planned for the theme of our pageant today, so ladies, pay attention. We would like for you to tell us your name, your title, and also a place that you would like to travel. I'm a teacher, so I'm going to say this again. Your name, your title, and a place that you would like to travel. At this time, could you please go ahead and make your way up to the stage?
Miss Gurnee 2011 and Little Miss Gurnee 2008. The place I would love to travel. travel to is Barcelona, Spain. Thank you. Have a great rest of your time.
Little Miss Annie. know she's the tiny princess from American Beauty, Illinois. She wants to go to Florida.
And this time, we like to move on to our formal wear and have a question phase of the competition. Each young lady can earn up to 25 points per judge. The judges are looking for grace, poise, confidence, and their formal wear selection. Does their dress reflect their personality and true essence? Prior to the pageant, each contestant selected a sealed envelope containing a random question. Little and junior contestants will receive one question, and our Miss contestants will receive two. The judges will evaluate how well the question is answered and was she confident in her delivery. We will now begin with our Little Miss contestants. Please welcome contestant number one, Aria Adia. Aria's favorite thing about being a kid is that you can explore new activities and get lots of love from your parents and your teachers. Are you ready for your pop question? Your question is, what is your favorite thing to do in the car?
My favorite thing to do in the car is look outside. Because who knows what you can see? Maybe there is like a small lake near a road, and then you can just see if there's any fish coming out.
Annabelle Harrell. favorite thing about being a kid is playing outside with her family and friends and having as much fun as possible. Are you ready for your pop question? Your question is, what is your favorite room in your house and why?
The favorite room inside the house is probably my room. I have lots of makeup, so I have my room in there. I also have my bed. Reference, use a bed.
Thank you. aware and pop question. First we have contestant number one, Madeline Rasmussen. Madeline's role model is her brother Dominic, because he enlisted in the military to help protect and serve our country. If you had a robot for one day, what would you ask it to do and why?
If I had a robot for a day, I would ask it to go fetch my friend, or my best friend, because then we could spend the whole day together, because I love her so much, and I like spending time with her, and it's just fun. Thank you.
Her favorite book is Divergent. Madeline's favorite subject in school is math. And when she's not busy with all of her activities, you can catch her watching her favorite movie, Stick It. Thank you, contestant number one, Madeline.
Thank you.
formal wear and pop question with our Miss Division. Please welcome to the stage contestant number one, Emily Hedman. Emily's role model is former Miss Gurnee Jessica Schwartz. She taught her to chase her dreams the way she chased hers by becoming a singer and songwriter. Emily's dream is to become a nurse someday, and Jessica's inspiration will help her to achieve that goal. Are you ready for your first pop question? Your first question is, when you think about all of the compliments you've ever received, what is one that stands out as being the most meaningful?
One of the best compliments I've ever received is how kind I am. Sometimes I feel like I'm not as kind to others, but when people say I'm filled with kindness and I light everyone with joy, it really makes me happy. Thank you. Recently, actually, is I started golf lessons, and I go to the golfing range with my mom all the time, and we're obsessed with trying to at least hit the ball off the tee. It's making a little bit of like progress, but with a little bit of practice, I'm sure we can do it one day. Thank you.
There is so much to experience and see in life, and she wants to be a part of it all. Emily's spirit animal is the wolf, because wolves are intelligent, crave freedom, and have an awareness of the importance of social connections. Thank you, contestant number one, Emily. Welcome to the stage, contestant number two, Bella Jansen. Bella's role model is her older brother, Trent. She has watched her brother mature these past few years to grow into a prime example of what self-confidence and hard work can create. He has manifested a beautiful life for himself, despite many people who doubted him as he was growing up. Are you ready for your first question? Your first question is, what is one item you would put in a time capsule that would represent this stage of your life and why?
If I were to put one item in a time capsule that would represent this stage of my life, my parents wrote me a beautiful letter just to reflect in the past 4 years. I did just graduate high school, and this letter means a lot to me, so I'd be sure to put this in the time capsule because it really not only it helps me focus back on what I was able to accomplish in the past 4 years, but also my parents are my biggest support system, so I make sure that I have it on me. Thank you. Falling. I am extremely clumsy and I fall all the time. It has happened before. I was going up the stairs, like running to class, and I did fall and I both went everywhere. So I think after that, it kind of scarred me a little bit. So I'm going to say falling. Thank you.
Treat yourself like someone you love. The foundation of all healthy relationships start with each individual loving themselves and projecting that love onto those around them. Bella's spirit animal is a wolf, because wolves are generally associated with intelligence, instinctiveness, and freedom. They follow their instincts above all else. Thank you, contestant number two, Bella. Miss contestants to the stage for their ensemble review. And this concludes the competitive portion of our pageant. I would like to invite our queens over for a little surprise.
Thank you.
that goes to contestant number two, Michaela Brown. And last but definitely not least, our fourth specialty award is for fanciest formal wear. And I'm guessing you know who I'm going to say, contestant number three, Annabelle Harris.
Opportunity. star of my community. I'm only 8 years old, but I have a bright future ahead. I will continue to learn and grow into the best version of myself. Thank you to the Gurney Pageant directors for giving us such a great and memorable year. Thank you to my family and friends, to my sister, who are the closest. Sorry, that was my running nose.
Thank you forever and always, your little Miss Gurney 2020.
Academy pageant by placing first runner-up. You have been a role model to all the young girls your age, and that is something that you should be extremely proud of. Keep up all your hard work, and we can't wait to see what other great things that you will accomplish. We hope to see you back here in a few years competing for Junior Miss. Maybe? Yes. So on behalf of the Gurney Community Pageant Committee, it is my honor to present you with a scholarship check, and thank you for being part of the Gurney community.
Don't worry, I haven't told anyone.
Thankfully, it makes for a great photo op. Thanks to Cassidy for being the best pageant stagehand we could ask for. Where would we have been without you? To the new junior miss, I know you will be a great role model and will represent Gurnee with pride. Be sure to create a special bond with your sister queens because they will become family. Your crown is not a trophy, but a symbol of strength, drive, and passion. Remember, your crowning moment lasts only minutes, but the memories you will make will last a lifetime. This year means the world to me, and I'm so thankful for all the memories we made together. I'm sad to be ending my reign as Junior Miss Gurnee, but I'm excited to continue making a difference as Junior Miss Lake County 2021. For the last time, I am your Junior Miss Gurnee 2020, Morgan Pettis.
You have done such a wonderful job representing Gurnee this year. Morgan was crowned Junior Miss Lake County at the Lake County Illinois State Pageant this past April. You have such a passion and drive for volunteering, and it makes us all proud that you are a part of this program. I know that it's been a difficult year for you, but you still managed to attend many events that positively impacted our community. Keep up all of your hard work, and we can't wait to see what the future holds for you. We hope to see you back in a few years competing for the title of Miss Gurnee. On behalf of the Gurnee Community Pageant Committee, it is my honor to present to you with this scholarship check, and thank you for being a part of our Gurnee Pageant family.
Women possible, and girls that I can call sisters for life. I like to say everything happens for a reason, and meeting you two has proved that. This year wouldn't have been as fun and cheerful without you by my side. Melanie, you have become a sister to me over this last year, and watching you grow and embrace your personality has been truly awing. I'm going to miss you teaching me all of the TikTok dances in the car and our silly selfies on the way to events. You have brought out my inner child, and for that, I am immensely grateful. You showed me that it's okay to laugh and smile at silly things, be curious about the world, and to feel joy again. I hope you continue to laugh, and I hope you continue to never let anybody dim your shine. Thank you for being my best friend and sister queen forever. Your voice and grace has shined through this year with you being so enthusiastic about improving our community. You have read books to children and encouraged them to read and improve their reading, and I hope that you choose someday to put my books in your library when you become a librarian. I would even leave you a few signed copies. I'm going to miss all of your Melanie poses and all the pictures we had for you to take because our eyes were closed. I'm going to miss seeing you in your beautiful dresses and getting to see you be a wonderful big sister to your brothers and sisters. This isn't goodbye, this is a see you later because you will forever be my little Miss Gurney of 2020. Morgan, it's been a roller coaster watching you grow throughout this last year. Your drive and ambition remind me so much of myself when I was your age. The world interests you, and you bring yourself everywhere you can dip your toes in. You have been a true role model, not only for me and Melanie, but for everyone in this room and any young girl. From doing two sports, tumbling, learning another language, and attending over 80 events throughout this last year, you have done nothing but shy and amaze me. Your platform serving our seniors has had a huge impact on me and the community members we support because you bring your creativity and heart into every project you lead. Not all of our seniors have support, and not all of our seniors have family, but you have given them a sense of love and belonging for your platforms. Kim and Al, you are incredibly lucky to have a daughter as bright and determined as Morgan. And Morgan, you are beyond lucky to have two parents that would do anything to see you happy and succeeding. Al, I would like to thank you for being the pageant dad at all of our events, to bringing us Culver's and to doing most of the work at our Royal Car Wash. Kim, I would like to say that you are an absolute powerhouse, and I am beyond lucky to have met you this year. Marvelli, you have touched my heart this year by treating me as your own. From lending me dresses for events and buying me a gown I could not refuse if I wanted to, you have made me the happiest girl. Melanie is lucky to be raised by a family with so much love and care. To Cassie, you have been my best friend and my biggest supporter throughout this last year. And you've also been a mom to me. You make sure that I'm always ready for events and that we try to be on time, because let's be honest, I'm always late to something. I'm incredibly grateful to have met you throughout this last few years, and I look forward to spending the rest of my reign with you as Miss Lake County. To all the strong women that I've met throughout this year, it is you who has inspired me the most. You have shown me what true poise is and have graced me with your experiences in life. Without you, I wouldn't be encouraged to be the woman that I am today. To the new Miss Gurney Queens this year, I am incredibly excited to work with all of you. And we have so many great contestants, and I can't wait to see who our new queens will be. The Miss that wins this year, I know she will continue to grace the stage with poise and serve our community wonderfully. As Howard Zinn said, we don't have to engage in grand heroic actions to participate in the process of change. Small acts, when multiplied by millions of people, can transform the world. Thank you for all being a part of the change. Thank you. And this is my last time as your Miss Gurney 2020.
watch you grow and mature into the young woman who stands on the stage beside me today. You have done an incredible job representing Gurnee throughout the craziness of this pandemic year. You have style, grace, and a passion to serve. Mia was also crowned Miss Lake County at the LCIS Academy this April and will continue her work on behalf of foster children. We are so proud of everything that you've accomplished and can't wait to see how your journey continues. On behalf of the Gurnee Community Pageant Committee, it is my honor to present you with this fellowship check and thank you for being a part of the Gurnee Pageant family.
Thank you.
Contestant number two, Bella Davis.